Today's discussion would be regarding the heart. This is a model of the heart. Heart lies in the mediastinum, in the middle part of the mediastinal cavity. These are the pulmonary cavities and this is the mediastinal cavities. The heart has got several surfaces. This is the anterior surface of the heart. It's also known as sternocostal surface. It consists mainly of the right atrium and right auricle and the right atrium, right ventricle. This is the anterior sternocostal surface of the heart. Mostly right atrium and the anterior wall of the right ventricle. The inferior surface is the diaphragmatic surface. This is the diaphragmatic surface, which lies on the dome of the diaphragm. This is the diaphragmatic surface and it consists mainly of the right and the left ventricle. The other surface is posterior surface, behind. This is the posterior surface of the heart. The posterior surface of the heart has got left atrium and the pulmonary veins. And this is how it is lodged in the mediastinum, posterior surface of the heart. The pulmonary veins bringing oxygenated blood into the left atrium. All right, now we come to the bigger model. This is a bigger model of the heart, and this is almost twice the size of the normal heart. Now let's discuss with the chamber. First we start with the chamber of the right atrium. This is right atrium. Right atrium stretches between the inferior vena cava inferiorly and superior vena cava superiorly. This is the whole is right atrium. Right atrium has got an auricle, or also known as appendage. This is the right atrial appendage, or right auricle. Now I'll show you the inside of the right atrium. I've opened up the anterior wall. I've taken away the right auricle or right appendage to show you inside. And inside you can see the inferior vena cava opening. This is the inferior vena cava opening. This opening is the opening for coronary sinus. The coronary sinus brings the venous blood to the heart. This is coronary sinus, and this coronary sinus opens over here in the right atrium, just besides the inferior vena cava. They have got valves, but these valves are not functioning, non-functioning in the adult. Now, above this you see a hollow, shallow fossa. This is fossa ovalis. Fossa ovalis is the fossa formed by the foramen ovalis present in the fetus. This is known as the limbus of the fossa ovalis, and this is the septum of the fossa ovalis. The limbus is formed by the septum secundum, and fossa is formed by the primary septum. So this is fossa ovalis, which is closed. And it is open at the time of the in the fetus to divert the fresh blood and shunt away from the lung. So that's fossa ovalis, and this is the opening of the superior vena cava. This smooth part having the inferior vena cava, superior vena cava, fossa ovalis is derived from the sinus venosus. And this is the muscular part. Muscular part consists of the appendage. Muscular parts consist of the muscle fibers, which are very rough, and these are confined to the auricle. So the atrium develops. Right atrium develops from two components: from sinus venosus, which is very smooth, and from the primitive atrium, which is muscular. Now, the blood comes in the atrium from the inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava and the coronary sinus. Now this drains into the right ventricle. The communication between the right atrium and the right ventricle is through this tricuspid valve. This is atrioventricular valve between the atrium and ventricle, and it is tricuspid on the right side, having three cusps. And I'll open up the ventricle wall now. This is, try to open up the ventricle. You can see the inside the right, this is the right ventricle. And this has got three cusps. One anterior cusp, the other one is posterior one, and the third one is septal cusp. So these are the three cusps, and the inside of the right ventricle has got a number of ridges. These are a number of ridges which sends these cord-like fibrous elements, cordae tendini, which gets attached to the cusps, and this prevents the cusps or valve going back inside the atrium when the ventricles contract. These are cordae tendini. These are papillary muscles which are attached to it. These are papillary muscles which are attached to the cordae tendini. And if this cordae tendini breaks away, then the valves may become incompetent. Valves may not close properly. Now, blood comes from the right atrium and goes into the right ventricle. And from the right ventricle, it will go into the pulmonary trunk. This is the pulmonary trunk. This is the pulmonary trunk through pulmonary valves. Now, inside of the right ventricle also contains certain more standing out tissues, fibers. This is the moderator band. Moderator band is the band which contains the right bundle of right bundle which comes from the atrioventricular and goes into the right bundle, into the right side of the heart. This one, moderator band, very prominent. This is the pulmonary trunk. Pulmonary trunk is guarded by pulmonary valve, semilunar pulmonary valve. These are semilunar pulmonary valve, same as the aortic valve, semilunar pulmonary valve. Let me also show you the conducting system. The conducting system of the heart consists of sinoatrial node, AV node, atrioventricular bundle, and the right and the left branches, left bundle and the right branches. The sinoatrial node is just over where the inferior vena cava opens over here, sinoatrial node. AV node is over here at the lower end near the atrial septum. And then it traverses AV bundle, atrioventricular bundle, and then it branches out into the right and the left branches, right bundle and the left branches. And then they go towards, end up in, as the Purkinje fibers. That is the rhythmic contraction, that is, which is the conducting system of the heart. Now, that completes our right side of the heart, right atrium, right ventricle, atrioventricular valve, and the pulmonary valve. Now let's come to the right atrium. If you look at the anatomical position, right atrium is almost in front of the left atrium. Right ventricle is almost in front of the left ventricle. So left ventricle is very posterior. This is because the heart is starts in the midline, and then it rotates towards the left side. So the left side becomes